When I think about real life skills that I want my kids to acquire as they grow up, so it's not the academic capability, but more the real life skills that they need to acquire. I think the one that stands out the most for me is public speaking. Because with that, it involves the confidence of standing up and speaking. It involves structuring thoughts in a certain way, so they have many thoughts and how to best structure it. And the third is how to think about their audience and to better customize it for their audience, what to include and what not to include, and how do I lose them, how do I get their attention. Because I work with different businesses and founders and managers across different countries, and the people who stand out are not the ones that have the most known degree from a famous college, or they work for a certain company and that company carries their name. The ones that stand out are the ones that are able to control a room in a sense where they're able to speak, articulate clearly, they're able to structure their thoughts, they're able to customize for the audience. Those are the ones that speak out, that stand out more than the others. But for us to teach that skills, so things that I'm experimenting with my kids, when we look at a certain topic and so on, I ask them to tell me, what did they see? How do they feel about it? So I asked them to share with me and my son. So those are things that I asked them to set up and do. I look at videos that their schools share with us as parents about them speaking. When I see them not giving the right eye contact with the audience, so like looking around randomly or reading from a paper, I point that out, saying that you need to work on that. So I do that systematically. Also, when I see them standing and reading from papers, even though all of their friends are doing it in the video, I don't care. It's about you and how you're able to have enough information to share about that topic that you're speaking around at school. I also look for topics that they care about. So for example, with my son, it was difficult for me to involve him in cultural aspects at the beginning when he was young, but he was, and still is, fully obsessed with Mario. So what I asked him to look at and prepare are information related to the games he likes. So Mario and the characters and what they wear and what superpowers they have and what are tricks he does in the game and so on. That gets him excited, that gets him interested, that gets him to involve the standing up and speaking, structuring the thought process, customizing for that audience. That is me. What I'm discussing is not straightforward, it's not easy to do, but I feel it's one of the key components that I would systematically be doing with them as they grow older. And I think that's something systematic, not just when they're young, you know, as they're growing, to make sure that specific skill